Hi, it's Lily Amanda for Portrait Creatives. In this video, we are going to talk about how to remove hair in front of the eyes. It can be tricky when you have flyaway hair fall in front of the eyes. So when I shoot, I really make sure there's no flyaway hair in front of the eyes because it's really time consuming to do this part of retouching and it's best to avoid it. Sometimes you have to zoom in to 100, 200, 300% sometimes to go into the details to retouching the hair. I will highly recommend you, like, make sure, just always make sure there is no flyaway hair in front of eyes. In case you catch one of those moments that you really love the image but just feel hair in front of the eyes, I'm going to show you how you can retouch those hair, remove those hair inside Photoshop. Let's go into Photoshop. So have a look at this image. This is a beautiful Amber and we have collaborated a few shoots and she also is one of the dance models I did for a dance project. I'm going to zoom in to see this image. So what I just did was to remove the flyaway hair. Over here, look at that. I just removed that. And that's in the previous tutorial. So I only take a few seconds to remove that hair. If you want to know how to do it, make sure you check out the previous video. Okay, so I'm gonna move on from that. And you see there are a few strands of hair over here, right? Okay, so you see, I have to zoom in like now it's 200% already. And that's about right. And to remove this hair. So I'm going to even zoom into 300 here. Now, you see, that is very time consuming. But the good news is it's very doable. Okay, let me just flatten all these layers. Okay, flatten. And then I'm going to duplicate this layer. Okay, and then here's a patch tool. I'm going to use patch tool. Just remove this hair first. Okay. This can be done. Zoom out a little bit. These are the easy parts. The ones that are difficult is actually just in front of the eyes. And I'm going to zoom in just to show you how you can deal with this. So here is, you don't have to worry about that, but you see here, like cross the eyelid underneath here, they have a little bit black hair over there. So I'm just going to drag it over to the side. And just clone it. It's the same as cloning. And here, I'm gonna drag it to here, like that. Okay? It's not perfect. It's not perfect. So we'll do it again. Yes. And over here, gonna drag it to the eye white area. And here, also do it again over here, just to clone all this area. So use patch tool. You can use also. You can also use a clone stem tool, but I do find patch tool sometimes is very, very helpful in this situation. Like, I don't think it does a good job, so I'm going to do here first. So in this way, I will have more, I think, a workable area. That means I have more place I can drag my patch tool to, right? Because it's already clean, so I can drag over here. Like that. And here I can drag it over here. And this, I'm trying to drag it to the side, to the place where that it's nearby. So it will look similar color and tone when I zoom out. Okay, and also here. I'm gonna drag over here, I think it's a little bit. It's good to use a patch tool because it preserves the texture. And here also, we're gonna move it over here. And move it over here and this one. Okay, so we can zoom out, have a look. That looks pretty natural, right? And all we have to do is continue to do this part. I'm using only patch tool and it does a really good job. Okay. It's the same if you have any eyes fall under in the iris over here. All you have to do is just use the patch tool and drag it to the iris or this area, okay? And here I will drag exactly on the left just to line up the line, the crease. Okay, here and over here. Okay, so this one I'm going to just drag it on the side and also here. You can drag it this side. You get the picture, right? So you know what to do once you have this situation. You see, it takes a bit time, but it's very doable. Sometimes you use a smaller patch will be easier to clone because it works better with Photoshop. It's easier for Photoshop to calculate it, put it that way. Okay, so here. Okay, so you get the picture. And here is also, you can just do that. Let me just drag this area like this and just drag it on the side so it disappears. Just do it again. Okay, like that. Okay, so I'm just going to quickly remove this. You can just speed up to... You can speed up two times, whatever you like, you know. But I'm just going to do it this one, like this, so you get the picture, right? Okay, so let me just do this one. You might think this is difficult, but no, it's very easy. Like this, you go over. Maybe that's a little bit bleed. Let me just move over here so it has some similar data to work with. Like this, okay. And this, you might have to change the color, like use a clone stamp tool, because you see, I'm going to use a new layer. Clone stamp tool, 20%, because it's become a little bit darker because the hair. So I'm just going to use clone stamp tool and just clone over it like that. Okay, and brush over so the detail come back off here. Okay, like this, right? So it's disappeared. Let's see before and after. Before and after. You can also go in to see like this area. I can see some of the lines still visible. In this case, you just have to use clone stamp tool and use a 50% or 100%, just go over this small area. Okay, I'm going to use another layer on top of it and just clone this. It's very doable. I mean, it's quite easy actually. It's not a difficult job, it just takes time. Okay. Like this. I would clone a bigger part to go over so it could look more universal. So this is just have to do it manually, right? So you can see that's how you can remove the hair in front of eyes. I hope you find these tips helpful. And if you find value out of this video, please give it a thumbs up. And we will be uploading more helpful tutorials like this. So make sure you subscribe to our channel so you won't miss out any. And I'll see you in the next video.